with sound on board, by the way.
Hey, just so you guys, the guys that are actually the filming camera guys.
Yeah.
He's the drummer.
Oh. Cool.
Who's going to be playing the?
I learned the song 5 minutes.
So just trying to make a place for him to be involved.
We were thinking maybe he could just eat tacos in the background.
I'm not a perfect person. There's many things I wish I didn't do.
Can we do that again?
Yeah.
Just crank it. I think our first show was in the summer of 95. In my parents' backyard, which feels weird to say.
When we first started off, when we were in our teens, we were together all the time. And one of us would have an instrument on us and we would be creating something and feeding off of the other.
I kind of knew I loved music, but I never really saw it as a viable option for what I would do for the rest of my life, at least at that point.
Whenever I step outside, somebody claims to see the light. It seems to me that all of us have lost our patience.
So Doug, how does it feel to be the lead singer of a rock band?
Very good.
You know, is it weird everywhere you go having like screaming girls like chasing after you and stuff?
Yes.
It still blows me away that it's been 15 years and I get messages from fans and friends and family like, oh, it's playing here, it's playing here.
I'm not a perfect person. There's many things I wish I didn't.
One song overshadowing everything. You know, I've met people before and it's come out to them that I play in a band. Oh, what's the band name? Hoobastank. Hoobastank. Oh, okay. Then they later find out that the song is the reason and that's us. And they go, oh, the reason, you know? So sometimes it's the reason is bigger than Hoobastank. It just is what it is.
And so I have to say before I go that I just want you to know I've found
thing about that song is it's never really gone away. It is kind of more nostalgic, you know, it's because of, you know, they associate it with a great memory, like their wedding song or something. I think people associate it with, like, you know, a good time in their life.
And the reason is you. I'm sorry that I hurt you.
This album, the reason it's changed all of our lives, me specifically, it's changed my life. I mean, it's been a trip. It's been a real trip that 15 years later, still talking about it, still hearing it when we go to public places, hear it on the radio, on commercials, television shows. It's just insane. I never really thought too deeply about it before, but the fact that we're talking about it now, it's something I'm definitely proud of.
That's why I need you to hear. I found a reason for me to change who I used to be. A reason to.
I've seen people tag us and stuff when it gets to the "and the reason is," the whole bar starts singing it.
Reason is you.
it definitely brings me back to that moment, because that's something I don't think you can duplicate, even if we tried right now, like, hey, let's write a record like that. It's just a different time in our lives. And so to have new songs that kind of encapsulate what was going on with us personally at that time come out now, it's cool.
Do those things to you. And so I have to say before I go that I just want you to know I found a reason for me.
I'm stoked that fans just kind of stick with us, and we've tried new things, and we've tried old things, and still have a core group of folks that come out and buy the records and still want to hear the songs.
And the reason is you. I've found a reason to show a side of...
It just took me back to a particular time that was an extremely fun time, hectic time, stressful time, amazing time. And it just feels good to kind of revisit it again.
And the reason is...